It's a continuation of the first clip, okay. What I was saying is math.min, okay. So it will return the minimum of two numbers. So let us do one example, okay. Yes. See here. This. Suppose, see the example, int n is equals to math.min 4,6. So this minimum function states that it will result in a minimum, it will return the minimum value among these two entered values, okay. Within the bracket, whatever we write, that is known as argument of parameter, okay. Whatever we write within the bracket is known as argument or parameter. So what is minimum out here between 4 and 6? 4. So it will return what? An integer type. Why? Because both the values are of type integer, that's why it will return an integer value. That is, the value of n will be 4 and its the return type will be int. That's why it was saying, you know, out here that the return value depends on the value used as an argument. So whatever the argument you are passing, whatever the value you are passing out here as an argument, it will return that after the execution is over. Fine. So let us see the next example. See here, that is double n is equals to math.min, it is 4.6 and 2.8. So both the numbers are in point, okay. So it will return what? Double, not float, okay. Always remember, it will return in double. Why? Both are in decimal. So which is minimum out of 4.6 and 2.8? 2.8 is minimum, so that's why it will return a double type data type whose value of n will be 2.8. Similarly, double x is equals to math.min -3.5, -9.5. So what it will return after the execution is done? Definitely, as the numbers are in point, so it will return the double data type and the minimum value, okay, and the minimum value for x, okay, and the minimum value between -3.5 and -9.5 is what? -9.5. As there is a negativity sign, so the bigger number will be known as the smallest, okay. So that's why the value of x will be -9.5, yeah. So just like this min, there is another function known as math.max, okay. Math.max, same, just the opposite. Minimum means it was giving you the minimum, here it will give you the, it is used to find the maximum between two arguments. Let us see the example. See, int n is equals to math.max 4,8. So maximum out here is what? 8. And what type of return it will give us? It will give us the return type as int. Why? Just like minimum, based on the input, based on this parameter, both the parameters or both the arguments are of type int. That's why it will return an integer data type, okay, whose maximum value will be what? 8. And it will be stored where? In n. Clear? Okay, next example. Similarly, double n is equals to math.max 12.7, 8.4. Okay? So this will return a double data type whose maximum value of n is how much? 12.7, 8.4. It will return 12.7 and its data type what? It will be a double data type. Yeah? So in if there are negative, okay, if there are negative numbers, see, -67.66, -97.45. So which one is maximum? Whichever number is nearer to zero, okay. So -67.66 is nearer to zero than -97.45. So that's why your maximum will be 67, and its return type will be what? Double. Yeah. Okay. So next example. Next example is math dot pow. Okay. So this function is used to find the value obtained when a specified base is raised to a given power. This is a power function. For example, see out here. So it's written double d is equals to math dot pow 2.0, 3.0. Okay. So what does this example says? Okay. What does this example says? Okay. Yes, let us write in a copy. Okay. So double d is equals to math dot pow 2.0, 3.0. So what does this mean? Is this is the base and this is known as the power. Yeah. So it means, okay, it means what? 2.0 to the power 3.0. okay, means it is 2 to the power 3, that is equals to 8.0. so the value of d will be 8.0. and why 0.0? Because both the numbers are in point, that's why it will return you a double. It will return you a double, double type, return type, return type. Yeah. So the return type of pow function. What is pow? Pow is the power. Okay, pow means it's a power. Yeah. So next example. See, there is double d is equals to math dot pow 5.0, okay, 5.0 to the power -2.0. okay, so how you will write this? So double d is equals to math dot pow 5.0, -2.0. so out here the power is what? So this is base and this is the power. It means what? 5.0 to the power -2.0. Yeah. So how we will do this? So this minus has to be converted to positives. How? So 1 upon 5 to the power 2. Yeah, we have to do in this manner. So 1 upon 5 square means how much? 5 is 25. So you divide 1 with 25. Zero, isn't it? So 25 will not be divisible by 1. So if we add 0.10 is added. Again, it is not divisible. So add 10. So 25 fours are 100. So your answer will be how much? So if the question comes like this, so what you have to do? This negative sign, okay, this negative power has to be converted to positive, like this. 1 upon this minus will be converted to positive. How? by taking this power to the denominator, 1 upon 5 to the power this 2. Yeah, so 1 upon 25, that is equals to, if we divide 25 with 1, so our answer will be 0.04. So that is equals to 0.04, and its data type it we were double. Clear? Understood?